Instead of suffering through the YouTube chat, click like and subscribe.
Before we get to All In, there is breaking news, and it is still not completely confirmed, although many of the major websites, including Fightful, is going with this. Gunnar Udy, the son of Sid Vicious, on Facebook has posted, "In memory of my father, Sid Udy, dear friends and family, I am deeply saddened to share that my father, Sid Udy, has passed away after battling cancer for several years. He was a man of strength, kindness, and love, and his presence will be greatly missed. We appreciate your thoughts and prayers as we grieve this loss. Details for a memorial service will be shared soon. Thank you for your support. Sincerely, Gunnar Udy." We'll see if we get any more details on this before the end of the show, but a real surprise, a real kick in the gut for me, Filthy. I was a big fan of Jim Crockett Promotions, and in 1989, they were bought in late 88 by Ted Turner, and the regime started to change, and there were some really great things that happened in 89, and there were some really tough things to watch, but one thing that was so easy to watch was seeing Sid Vicious and Danny Spivey get in there and just destroy people, and Sid Vicious throwing power bombs, and this is supposed to be the next big heel in the company, and the fans couldn't help it. You couldn't help it but look at Sid Vicious and see all of the physical charisma and see his look and see him start looking around as the fans would start chanting and picking up people and power bombing them again. Sid Vicious, Sid Justice, Sid, Psycho Sid was awesome, and he may not have been the greatest professional wrestler in the world, but damn it, was he professional wrestling.
Yeah, you can't put it much better than that, Mike. My earliest memory of Sid was watching him absolutely decimate poor Brian Pillman in the cage in early 90s WCW, and then
War Games,
and then moving on to become a main eventer in the WWF as Sid Justice, who was screwed by Hulk Hogan. Yeah. We should be living in a world where Sid Justice won the Royal Rumble and was the champion, but instead the big babyface Hulk Hogan pulled him over the top rope, claiming he was screwed in a match in which it's every man for himself. And, you know, many people thought that was going to be it for Sid. His reign at the top was going to be short-lived. He had wore out his welcome already, but years later, I will never forget, as a man who loves a good entrance, perhaps my favorite professional wrestling entrance of all time is Sid coming out at Survivor Series to face HBK for the title in New York City, Madison Square Garden, in front of the most hardcore of hardcore, smarkiest fans of the time. You would think a guy like Sid would be looked down upon, buried. He walks out, and the people go crazy for this guy. Everybody in Madison Square Garden wanted a fist bump. They wanted to get those crazy eyes looking at him from the master and the ruler of the world. And they got it because he won that belt that night. And I thought it was a great moment. Like I said, one of my favorite entrances of all time and really one of my favorite memories as a teenager of professional wrestling. So if you ever ask me, I'll tell you, Sid rules
the world. His singles match with Shawn Michaels at Survivor Series, arguably his best singles match of all time. He also had a couple with Bret Hart in the time that he was with WWE, then WWF as well. He talked about the War Games match where he unintentionally injured Brian Pillman, but it did give us a memory, and it gave some reality to the dangers of that kind of match where a guy can injure his shoulder. And again, not the best pro wrestler in the world, but what a great character. You talk about the garden, Look at ECW Arena. Look at how those people would treat some of the folks that would come in, like they treated Matt Bourne when he came in. But then Sid comes in, and you cannot help it. He walks in there, and everybody wants to see him wreck shop. It didn't matter who he killed. They just wanted to see him go out there and kill somebody. Another amazing Sid visual that we would get in the WWF was something that Bruiser Brody did one time in Georgia, where he took a guy, beat a jobber up so bad, threw him in a wheelchair afterwards, and then ran him into the ring post. Well, they updated that for Sid in the WWF, where a guy would be laid out after getting killed by him on Superstars or on Challenge, and they would roll the poor bastard outside of the ring. They would put him on the gurney, and then Sid, as they were rolling him up the aisle, would get the gurney and either roll him back and knock him into the post, or just flip the thing over, and the guy falls face first on the ground. It was just, again, another great visual that they did to get that guy over as a monster when he came up to the WWF. And Tom, another one that I remember, you talk about him getting screwed by Hulk Hogan when he was still Sid Justice, and they made the call to give Hulk Hogan the title match. And it was so cartoonish, but it was so great because Sid was this big, over-the-top pro wrestling cartoon character. And you see him just kind of trying to smile, and they make the decision, and he balls up the paper, and it's really over the top. But it was, again, just such a great memory that, you know, again, 20 years later, whatever we are from it, that I can think about in this time.
Yeah, Mike, I mean, we could go on and on. We haven't even talked about his WCW run at the end, in which he was the champion for, you know, a good portion of it. Really, he was the top babyface at one point towards the end. So, I mean, a storied career. And like you said, it's such a great way to put it. He was not the best pro wrestler, but he was a great professional wrestler.
Yeah. Yes. Yes, he was. You know, even right down to the unfortunate end for him. And after this, he was able to actually go out and make some indie appearances and all that sort of stuff. But you talk about the end of WCW and a lot of the things that took place then being wrapped up in the Chris Benoit title issue, when he defeated Sid with Sid's foot under the rope, and when the Radicals jumped to the WWF, they made the decision, put Arn Anderson out there to return the title to Sid. And then you had the moment where at WCW Sin, he jumped off the top rope, compound fracture on live pay-per-view, a Joe Theismann Monday Night Football type of moment, and unfortunately ended that portion of his career.
Which, by the way, they decided to replay on Nitro.
Yes, they did. In fact, they opened the show with a still shot of it, I believe, with the leg over to the side, what? And him holding it and all that. It was, yeah.
What is this, Faces of Death?
At that point, actually, yes. They just didn't know it was going to be the company that was going to be killed. But
hey, if you love this clip, have I got a deal for you. WrestlingObserver.com. Do you have a commute? Do you work out at the gym? Do you like listening to audio on your headphones or your earbuds or whatever the kids use today? Well, WrestlingObserver.com will give you all the audio you'll ever need in your life. Over 15,000 audio shows. Every audio show that we have ever done, dating back to 2005, is available for subscribers at WrestlingObserver.com. Every time a new show comes out, you can podcast it directly to your phone. If you have a commute, as noted, if you go to the gym, if you like to lift weights and listen to Granny review soap operas, well, WrestlingObserver.com gets you full access to all of these shows and all of these archives. You can go back and listen to TNA reviews from 2010. You can go back and listen to reviews of every WWE pay-per-view, every big story that's ever happened in wrestling. You can get access to that at WrestlingObserver.com. Plus, full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter every week. 40,000 words of news and information in pro wrestling. Why get all your scoops off Reddit, which aren't even accurate most of the time? Go right to the source, the Wrestling Observer newsletter. You also get Observer archives dating back to 1990. So check it out today. thousands of issues of the Wrestling Observer newsletter, tens of thousands of hours of audio, all for $12.99 per month or as low as $9.99 if you sign up for a year. You'll never run out of audio if you subscribe to WrestlingObserver.com. So head up there, check it out today, and I'll talk to you again after a while.